Hi kids! Welcome to our virtual classroom. I am Teacher Kay and join me as we learn and have fun in our lessons here at Teacher Kay's Learning Hub. English 2, Quarter 1, Week 3. Common and proper nouns. The lesson in this video will help you to identify what is noun, differentiate common from proper noun, and recognize common or proper noun in simple sentences. Let us have first a pretest. Write C if the underlined word or words are common noun and P if it is proper noun. Write your answer on your whiteboard. Number 1. The children listen attentively. The underlined word is children. Number 2. She uses cell phone in taking pictures. The underlined word is cell phone. Number 3. Dr. Robert F. Santos is humble and caring. The underlined word is Dr. Robert F. Santos. Number 4. Many people cannot go home in their provinces. The underlined word is provinces. Number 5. We celebrate National Heroes Day every August. Now let's look back to our past lesson. Identify each picture. Write inside the box if it is a person, place, animal, or thing. Now let's check your answers. Number 1, thing. Number 2, animal. Number 3, place. Number 4, thing. And number 5, person. Let us have a brief introduction of our lesson. A name of person, place, animal, thing, or event is called noun. A noun can be used in simple sentences. It can be written in any parts of a sentence. Let us take some examples using pictures. The flower is beautiful. The mountains are high. The boy is neat and handsome. The words flower, mountains, and boy are called nouns. These nouns are called common nouns. The word flower refers to a general name of thing. The word mountains is general name of place. And the word boy is general name of person. Also remember that common nouns begin with small letters. Andres Bonifacio was brave and clever. Brownie is cute and barks softly. The words Andres Bonifacio and Brownie are nouns. These nouns are called proper nouns. For our activity 1.1, get your crayons and module. Color the common nouns pink and the proper nouns yellow. Here Here are the given words. Caloocan City, Street, Emilio Aguinaldo, Mother, Principal, Christmas, Garden, Samson Room, Library, Tagpi, Mall, Dr. Carlo R. Santos. Let's check your answer. The words that you must color it pink are street, garden, library, mother, principal, and mall. Did you got it right? Good job! The words that you must color yellow are Caloocan City, Emilio Aguinaldo, Samson Road, Christmas, Tagpi, and Dr. Carlos R. Santos. Do you got a perfect score? Well done! For our next activity, group the nouns inside the cloud using a tree map. Then write each noun under the proper heading. Clinic, Pedro, Laptop, Cat, Crayon, Bantay, City, Webster, Caloocan Monument, Santa Cruzan. Here are the words under common nouns. Clinic, laptop, cat, crayon, and city. Here are the words under proper nouns. Pedro, Caloocan Monument, Bantay, Webster, Santa Cruzan. For our activity number 2, read the sentences. Underline the common nouns once and the proper nouns twice. The teacher teaches well. Our dog is small and barks softly. Number 3, they use cell phone in their online classes. Number 4, we feel happy and excited during New Year. Dr. Robert C. Santos is hardworking and patient. Now let's check your understanding. Study the sets of pictures. Answer the question that follows. For set A, we have car, nest, and butterfly. What have you noticed on pictures in set A? What type of nouns do you think they are? For set B, we have Rene and Dr. Cruz, Mongol, and Nativity. What have you noticed on pictures in set B? What type of nouns do you think they are? Remember, nouns are names of persons, places, things, animals, and events. There are two kinds of nouns, common nouns and proper nouns. Common nouns are general names of persons, places, things, animals, and events. They begin with a small letter. Examples: actor, province, television, cat, occasion. Proper nouns are specific names of persons, places, things, animals, and events. They always begin with a capital letter. Examples: Viola Pascual, Bulacan, Muni, Independence Day. Now, you can answer post-test and reflection on page 8 of your English module, week 3. That's all for today. Hope you learned something. Don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel. Goodbye, till next time.